Hey guys! First of all, thank you for being here on the channel. I highly appreciate your support. In this video, I'm going to give you my 5 tips on how to boost your stock photography sales. Today I want to share with you my 5 tips on how to boost your sales. This video is for those of you who want to step up in stock photography, and some of these tips are usable also for you video guys out there who are watching this. Let's start with tip number 1. Brainstorm your keywords before you shoot. When you are new to stock photography or just finished one project and looking for inspiration on what to shoot next, try to brainstorm the keywords which are popular right now before you start shooting. You can inspire from recommendations provided by stock agencies at their sites. Those recommendations most often reflect what is in the highest demand right now. You can use also your local news and magazines as a source of inspiration. For sure, some topics are trending in fashion, food or technology right now. There is a chance someone out there is looking for your future content and is ready to buy. Tip number 2. Check your spelling. What I mean by this is always make sure your titles and keywords are grammatically correct with no typos. Sometimes the wrong spelling could bring you some traffic, but don't rely on it. Keywords shouldn't contain special characters or repeated words. Be careful, especially when naming non-English places and landmarks in your titles and descriptions. Tip number 3. Save your keywords as sets. This is more of a workflow speed-up hack. You know the situation very well. Sometimes you submit people, sometimes it's food, and sometimes it could be, I don't know, maybe animals. Every situation works with different basic keyword sets. What you can do about this in Adobe Lightroom and Capture One is you can configure your preferred keyword list for every situation and then just apply basic keywords without even thinking about it. After this baseline is done, you can be more precise and focus on the unique features of your image. In Lightroom, open the keyword set dropdown, and there you can configure your keyword sets. You can use 6 predefined keywords for every set. After your sets are configured, you can use them right away. In Capture One, on Metadata tab, you have the keyword library tool. If you don't see it, click View, Customize Tools, add a tool to Metadata tab, and from there select Keyword Library. Now you click these 3 dots and from there select Create Keyword Library. For every situation, you can create a small library to stay organized. For example, deserts with your basic keywords, then food, people, location, activity, season, and so on, depending on which categories you use the most. Now you just select your image and click the appropriate and relevant keywords based on your content. And your baseline is ready with 0 typing in few seconds. You can apply the keywords also to more images at a time, and this is what makes this tool so powerful. Tip number 4. Arrange keywords from the most important and specific to the least important and general. This can be done beforehand only in Capture One. If you are a Capture One user, take advantage of this feature. It will save you a lot of time spent while submitting your images to agencies. Place the 5 most relevant and unique keywords to your image at the beginning of the keyword sequence. When you export the file from Capture One, the keywords will be written to the file in your desired order. Based on this, some agencies will make the first few keywords the most powerful and relevant for their search engines. And tip number 5, make a revision of keywords on images or videos already submitted to stock agencies. By doing this, you can increase the potential of your sales. That means with the same set of photos, you could earn even more money online. So in case you have some images you already submitted and now you realize the keywords or descriptions are off, make a revision and update those assets. Sometimes doing a keyword cleanup can help you to boost sales of an image or video which was never sold before. And that's where I leave it. This video is a part of my keywording masterclass on Skillshare, when I talk more in depth about keywording techniques which can save you a ton of time and effort. I'm also showing the tools I use for making the keywording process as painless and easy as it gets. The link to the full course is in the description down below, so be sure to check it out. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you found some value in this video. Do you have your own techniques when it comes to increasing your stock sales? I wanna know, write it in the comment section. I'm happy to help you out on your creative journey, so don't forget to click that subscribe button for more inspiring content. See ya!